Peterson. I'm a reporter at Digiday. Let's talk about the latest step that Apple's taking in its whack-a-mole war against cross-site tracking. So Apple doesn't like how when people go to a website like example.com, you can have all these other companies that are monitoring what a person is doing on that website. It's kind of like online advertising's version of a three-way call where you think you're on the phone with just one other person. Little do you know, there's a third person sitting silently on the line listening to everything that you say. So in 2017, Apple rolled out a new feature for its Safari browser called Intelligent Tracking Prevention that it's been updating over the past 2 years to try to limit the ability of these third-party companies to monitor what people are doing on other sites. There have been two phases to Apple's war with cross-site tracking. In the first phase, it went after third-party cookies, which were these tracking identifiers that these third-party companies would drop on a website where they weren't the ones with the first-party relationship with a person. By taking away third-party cookies, Apple effectively took away that three-way calling option. But there are still cookies that websites can drop on people's browsers for good reason. I go to example.com, and example.com can say, hey, I'm gonna call you user 123. And so it'll drop a first-party cookie on the website so that the next time I go to example.com, it can say, hey, last time you were here, you were checking out this product. Are you still interested in that product? Are you interested in these other products that are similar to it? Or last time you were here, you were logged in, you never logged out, but we know you're user 123, we know you're good for it, we're gonna keep you logged in. First party cookies can be really valuable. They can also be really valuable for companies like Facebook and Google that had their third party cookies taken away. And so these companies figured out a way to use first-party cookies to work around Apple's limitations on cross-site tracking. Here's how they did that. So first-party cookies created an opportunity for these companies to still track a person, but there was a big limitation with them. Example.com might know I'm user 123, but that means nothing to these other companies who don't know me by that name or by that identifier. Facebook may have its own identifier in addition to knowing that I'm Tim Peterson. Google, same thing. Each of these other companies, the same thing. So they had to figure out a way how to match what example.com identifies me as with what they've identified me as. And so they've done this through a process called link decoration. So link decoration is exactly what it sounds like. It's a little extra information that's added to the URL of a link that a person clicks on. In this context, it's information that allows companies like Facebook and Google to continue to identify someone when they're on websites that they don't own. How it works is, let's say I'm on Facebook, I'm logged in, so Facebook knows I'm Tim, and Facebook monitors everything I do on Facebook, and so it's always keeping, updating its file it has on me of what I'm doing. So let's say I see an ad for example.com. When I click on that ad, Facebook's gonna record that click. They're gonna record it in what's called a click ID that's unique to that one individual click. So on Facebook, so Facebook sets a click ID for me, T1M, that it connects back to my Facebook account, the user ID that it has for me. It adds that click ID to the link when I go to example.com. So I'm not only going to example.com anymore. If I were to look at the URL, it would look actually. So then when I go to example.com, there's this extra information that's added to the URL. Example.com looks for this information and it stores it in a first party cookie. And now I am T1M. And so with that information, the first party cookie, then Facebook is running this code in the background on example.com that every time a page loads, it's looking for the first party cookie and it's looking for the ID in the first party cookie, the click ID. It looks for that ID, sends it back to Facebook to basically say, hey, do we know someone named T1M or do we have a click ID for a T1M? Facebook can then go check through its files and say, oh yeah, we do have a click ID for T1M. Oh, it's actually attached to this user, Tim. Okay, so we know Tim is on example.com. Great. We're just gonna, every time, you know, T1M is on that website, we know that that actually translates to Tim. And so as long as that first party cookie is there, and as long as Facebook is able to run the code in the background of example.com, which example.com lets Facebook do. Facebook can continue to know that T1M is on this website and that T1M is Tim in Facebook's identity graph. Apple isn't super wild about the potential for this, for Facebook to then use these first-party cookies to continue to track people persistently. So it's been putting limitations on how long these first-party cookies can stick around for. Earlier this year, it updated Intelligent Tracking Prevention to with update 2.1 to say these first-party cookies can only stick around for 7 days. That limits the ability for Facebook to be able to know that I clicked on an ad and purchased something on example.com, because I would have to make that purchase within a week of having clicked on the ad. If I do it 2 weeks later, then this first-party cookie is gone, and Facebook has no way of knowing that I'm still there. Then more recently, Apple updated it where this cookie, the T1M cookie, that first-party cookie, is deleted after 24 hours if it's been set through this process with the link decoration. So as a result, what that means is if I click out on Facebook and I go to example.com, if I don't buy a product from example.com within that initial 24-hour window, and let's say I want to sleep on it or I want to take a week and really think about if it's something that I want to buy, if I come back 2 days later, this cookie is gone, and so I purchased that product, but Facebook has no idea who I am, that I'm this person who clicked on this ad in the first place. And so that's the big headache that Facebook and Google and a lot of companies are now facing with how Apple is, you know, further restricting cross-site tracking on Safari.